It's the first week of November 2021. For the fourth time in my life, I'm not on the Isle of Wight. Everything you can see here has been reconstructed by green screen. Nice effects, Jeff. I was last not here in December of 2020 when I uttered this immortal line. The line closes for 3 months. Should be back up and running in April of 2021. That didn't quite happen. Instead, it's taken 7 months longer. But finally, here today, the Iden line is back open, up and running. The new trains, the Class 484s, the old D-stock from the District line, are here on the Isle of Wight.
Yes, these old District line tube trains have been converted by Vivarail, who make battery and diesel variants of these units too. To find out more about them, watch this video, and I made a trip to see them last year. There's a link in the description, along also with the farewell video to the 1938 tube trains video, which you can watch as well. It's very fitting that these District line units have been converted to run on the island, as it's now the third generation of tube trains to operate here.
The good news is that for the first time ever, it's not raining, I think, that I've been here. The bad news is that the low winter sun means we're going to have some silhouette issues, but that's okay. Can you see on the other side? They have raised the platform. So one of the things they've done, it's not just about new trains. Apparently they've done a lot of track work to make the ride less bumpy, more smooth, and they've raised the platform height as well to try and keep the level boarding with the new trains, the new Class 484s, which is about to pull in.
The Class 484s have got a smart, clean look for the interior with blue grab poles and a navy blue seat maquette. There's SWR branding, and they've retained the transverse seating configuration, which was always much loved on the District line.
So what you've got here is a Class 484. Now these are the Vivarail D-trains, D-stock trains, ex-District line trains. Remember, they're on the Bedford-Bletchley line, running as Class 230s. Here there is Class 484s, meaning that there's no toilets on these ones, and also their third rail, the Bletchley line, are actually, they've got engines on here. It's just all third rail traction. What I'm trying to work out is why there's a 60-minute service and they've doubled up two units. It's a two and a two for a four car. But as we pull into Shanklin, I've got a friend here who might just be able to explain.
Oi, oi.
It's the green team.
How are you?
How are you doing? You're right.
Martin?
Hello, Jeff.
Why is it a 60-minute service and not a 30-minute service?
That's a very convoluted question, well, quickly.
We should discuss that later, shouldn't we?
Indeed, we should.
I've met Sean. What are you doing?
I'm working for a deco with SWR with the new Iden line, helping people promote the new timetable and the trains.
Tell us about the new timetable and the new train, Sean.
At the moment, the timetable is every hour. However, they are trying to up it to every half hour. But as you can see, the only units that they've got here is 01 and 04 actually coupled together, one in. If you go to St John's Road, you can actually see there's a unit inside the shed, and that's 02 and 03, Jeff.
To get that eventual half an hour frequency, a new parting loop has had to be installed, as Martin explains.
Okay, so previously when there was a 20-40 minute frequency, there were passing loops at St John's Road and Sandown. Those passing loops are still existing, but now to implement the 30 minute headway, they've had to put a passing loop roughly halfway down the line. So they've now reinstated the passing loop that was taken out about 30 years ago in Brading platform.
So we will go and check that out later. We'll get out of Brading and have a look. I did know, from looking at the timetable, it's actually 24 minutes going south, but 25 minutes coming up. So it's a minute quicker going towards the mainland than it is going south. It must be on a slope. But that makes it very tight, because there's only 5 minutes. There's only 5 minutes turnaround at each end. If there's any delay, then it makes it very, there's not a lot of slippage time.
And this is without stopping at Smallbrook Junction, which only operates when the Heritage Railway runs, usually during the summer. As that would eat up more time, a couple of minutes into the overall journey, there was a rumour that the possibility of a separate Ride St John's Road to Smallbrook shuttle service being run on those days instead, so that the regular trains always skip Smallbrook and it's served by the shuttle instead.
Oh, and also Martin's friend Rob is here. Hey Rob.
Good morning.
Just in case you see, there's like double trouble. There's two of you.
Oh,
Rob?
Yes.
Can I get you to be my official door opener person? Thanks, Rob.
I think when they do the
It's just... It's quite slow.
Time to get out and have a look around at Brading to see all the work that's taken place.
So this platform of Brading hasn't been used for about 30 years because obviously they took the passing loop out, it wasn't needed. So they've obviously had to reinstate it. Now the footbridge, the old one, the black one, that had basically been condemned and there were signs on it saying one person on the bridge at any one time. So while they refurbished that, they built a temporary footbridge instead. Obviously people who have accessible needs, at the down end of the platform they put a ramp in at both ends. But what they haven't done, they haven't raised these platforms, which they have done for every other platform on the line. My understanding is all trains are using this platform, so nobody's got to cross over, nobody's got to use the foot crossing.
And there's clearly work still going on, because I can hear like drilling noises in the background.
On both platforms.
And it's like there's workmen doing stuff.
There's something going on over here.
So what we got, accessible path to platform two, there, but there's a gate which looks locked.
Now off camera, Martin and Rob are chatting to a workman over there. He's got permission to work over there. There's a sign here saying please latch gate, but the gate very definitely, but I'm pretty sure this was it a barrow crossing or a foot crossing? This used to be a public access footpath. And it's become a bit unpublic, and the workman is saying is that some ramblers have been through this morning unable to cross their regular footpath because they've now turned it into this accessible crossing, which isn't yet open. But I think come the December timetable, you should be able to use it.
Really done over there.
Rob's found a timetable. What you found?
Showing hourly. So hopefully, from the 12th of December, they may go half hourly.
I think, yeah, this is like hourly until December. It's only for 6 weeks, and then it will change to a 30-minute service.
The next station is Sandown.
And then it's time for a quick charge of my phone using the handy USB ports that are between the rows of seats on the side. And then we meet some passengers who are loving the new level access.
It's really good, it's much better for travelling with the pushchair. There's not much of a gap anymore, so it's more level for us to come on.
It is more level, so that makes it slightly easier.
Yes.
That's good, alright. And then back to Sandown, where I discovered that it's got a second entrance on the northbound side.
Did you know that Sandown was totally accessible on the northbound platform by this entrance on the western side of the station? Oh look, there's a little old, there's a thing in the wall. I never knew this was here.
They definitely raised the platform here. This is a new platform. Are we giving a thumbs up or a thumbs down to the train?
Oh, definitely a thumbs up. Big improvement, yeah, well done. We're rail community officers.
You are you just making sure that I'm behaving myself?
Absolutely.
Am I behaving myself?
Do you have a ticket?
I do actually, yeah.
That's what we like to see. Okay.
Next stop, Ride St John's Road.
There's a ramp here at Ride St John where we are, but there's still this footbridge over, and what I'm thinking right now is how the heck do you get step free to the southbound platform? Also, at Esplanade, it's definitely, because the platform there's on a curve, isn't it? It's on quite a curvy thing, and so even though it might be level, there's still a bit of a gap because of the curve. It's not a straight platform, which is awkward. But I think the boarding is a little better just because the platform heights are now, and the train are more even, which is obviously good, but I don't think it's 100% step free everywhere, I think. Martin, so 1 and 4 are out. What's behind you in the depot there?
Hopefully there, behind those yellow and black shutters, is 484, 002 and 003.
So where's 005? It sounds like James Bond, doesn't it?
It does.
Where's 007?
005 is still at Eastleigh, hasn't yet made its way across to the island.
Are you liking it?
I'm loving it. Oh, sorry, that's trademarked. I'm enjoying it very much.
who's trademarked, Martin? I really fancy a hamburger for some reason all of a sudden. I don't know why. is there one of those on the island?
There's two.
The old D-stock trains go through the tunnel at Ryde, no problems with the height clearance here, and that took us to our penultimate stop.
Made it to Ryde, Esplanade. Do you know, I still don't know, is it Esplanade or Esplanade? I've heard it pronounced both ways. The tide is way out, look at that, and we're waiting for the train to come down. I'm going to do one stop to the pierhead. They've definitely, can you see it by my feet, they've definitely refurbished the platform here. But as I say, it's on a curve, so There's still a gap.
So I'll make one last trip. I want to go and find where the accessible wheelchair area is.
Hello again.
Hello.
If only it had actual strap hangers. The bar's good enough. We're in the accessible area. There's a luggage rack. Handy, I think, in peak summer when a lot of people come over for the holidays. So that's interesting to see. And two flap down seats right there. Accessible area. You can totally. You can walk through into the next carriage like that, which seems really strange for a tube train.
And at Ride Pier, there's just enough time to buy myself a souvenir.
So if I give this man some dosh, he'll give me some change. Look at that. Nice. Thanks very much.
There we go.
Thanks for the bed.
And that is it. Martin, we're going to stick around and get the dramatic dusk shot with the drone, right? We're totally doing that to play out. That is the new Class 484 Island Line here on the Isle of Wight. Old D-stock tube trains, they're awesome. Come visit the Isle of Wight and ride the new trains. See ya.